If you wish to skip around this video, the chapters feature should be available. The current version for the mod is 0.6.9. Anything I cover in this video may or may not change in a future update. A guide to Camera2, a Beat Saber mod to customize different aspects of or add more cameras into your desktop view. Up-to-date information can be found on the mod's GitHub page. In there, you'll also be able to find the wiki. Where do you get Camera2? The easiest way is to go to a mod assistant near you, clicking the check mark, and then install or update. You could also manually download the mod from the GitHub page I mentioned before. When you first load into the game, you'll see nothing has changed in your headset view. But if you take a look at the desktop preview, you will see that the movements are already smoother. If this is all you wanted, you could have just turned on the smooth camera option in the settings. But this mod offers much more than that. Let's go into the mods panel on the left and find the button for Camera2. Ignore my other 700 mods. We are greeted with two screens. On this left panel, you will see your cameras. When first starting up, there should only be one called Main. I have two for video purposes. We'll come back here later on. Let's look at the panel in the middle. More settings will be found here. Let's start with the General tab. First, we have the ability to name cameras. If you end up creating many, this will come in handy for organization. Below, we can pick the camera type, first person or positionable. First person should be easy to understand. The camera is your eyes. Positionable allows you to place your camera wherever you'd like. It could also be called third person. In order to move it, aim your laser at the white object and hold down the trigger on your controller. Then, just move it around. You might notice that the camera will snap to different angles as you move it around. Feel free to use that however you'd like. Next in the settings, we have the field of view. Basically, a way of adjusting how much a camera can see. Under, we have the render scale, a setting to lower or increase the resolution of a camera. Increasing it can help with reducing the jagged edges on things. The default is 1.3. Anti-aliasing is another setting that can help you with jagged edges. Z offset tells the camera how far forward or back you want it to be. If you want to show your sabers and or swings more, try setting a negative value. X rotation offset helps rotate the camera up and down. If you naturally tend to look down when playing a chart, the setting can be used to bring the view back up. Pivoting first person offset changes the behavior of how the camera rotates. If your camera has a Z offset applied, you'll be able to tell what's different. Generally, you want to keep this setting on. The last option is to lock your camera, to prevent you from accidentally moving around your views when clicking around the desktop. The positionable camera also has a visibility toggle. The indicator can be set to always visible, have it hide while playing, or have it always hidden. The visibility tab allows you to toggle several things that the camera can and can't see. Walls. They can be visible, transparent, or hidden. Notes can be visible, hidden, or you can have the ability to force your custom notes. This one applies only if you have the HMD only option enabled on custom notes. For those with an avatar, it can be visible, hidden, or you can force it to be visible in the first person camera type. I'll show you an example of that later. You're also able to turn on or off debris, regardless of what the player option is set to. You can also toggle the cut particles, the UI, the floor you stand on, your sabers, and if all of that is not enough, you can hide everything else. The last options here set how far ahead a camera is able to see. These are presets, but you can manually edit the value in the config file for each camera. If you manually change and save any settings from the config file, you can reload your cameras by pressing Ctrl+Shift+F1 while focused on the game. The smoothing tab is pretty simple. Enabling force upright will tell the camera to keep your view level. It will ignore when you tilt your head to the sides. It will still show up and down though. Follow replay position is as it says. The camera will follow the view of the player as recorded by the replay, instead of your current headset position. These last two options, the lower the value, the smoother or slower the camera responds. Higher values become faster or snappier. First is position smoothing. This adjusts how the camera responds when you move around your space. Rotation smoothing adjusts how the camera responds when you look around or rotate your head. When the camera type is positionable, the smoothing tab gets replaced with a 360/90° tab. Here you can find settings to adjust how smooth or snappy the camera rotates with these charts. Modmaps is another easy tab. Out of visible walls forces walls to be fully visible during a modmap. Useful if you like to have your walls transparent or hidden normally. For example, with an avatar camera. Auto hide HUD will automatically hide your UI, like your score, combo, and so on. You will only hide it in your desktop view camera though, not inside your headset. Scenes. We'll get to that later on. The effects tab can also be pretty cool. Currently it allows your camera to have transparency. I will show examples of that later. Misc is the last tab you can find. Use orthographic projection can tell the camera to basically flatten out the image. I'll show how I use this later. Attach to spectator platform. This tells the camera to follow you or not as you're spectating a multiplayer. Enable movement script in menu. You can attach scripts to your camera that tell them to move around. This option allows for those to be active in the menu scene. Not sure how much I'll say about them in this video. When I said Misc was the last tab, I lied a little bit. You can enable one more tab called Display by clicking the Move Display on the left panel. This tab allows you to move and resize your cameras from within the game if you'd like. I prefer using my mouse though. That was a lot of information so far, but I have yet to add another camera, ignoring the second one here. Let's create a few and dive into scenes. Scenes are a way of setting up different cameras to display depending on what you're doing in the game. You can have a set of cameras showing in the menu, and a different set showing while you're playing a chart, or playing a mod chart, or a 360 map. There are different options. I'm going to start off by making a very simple use of scenes, two cameras. We'll have the main camera for the menu, and one to use while playing. All you should have to do is click on Add Camera and click on Configured. You could also give it a name if you'd like. Then let's go to the Visibility tab and turn off the UI toggle. Right now, you have two cameras running. The more you have running at the same time, the more performance hit you'll take, so be careful. In order to fix this, we go to the Scenes tab. We'll click on our main camera and assign it to the main menu. The camera we created a minute ago will hide away, leaving us with one again. It just got disabled, not deleted. Also, don't worry, if you don't assign cameras to other scenes, there is a system in place that makes it so there is always a camera visible no matter where you go. Now let's click back on our second camera and assign it to playing. Lastly, resize it to fill up the screen. Done. Almost forgot to mention how layers work. It's basically a way of saying which camera you want at the front and which camera should be at the back. For example, if you have a main camera and an avatar cam, you want the main camera to be on layer 0 and the avatar cam on layer 1 or above. Otherwise, it would be behind your main camera and therefore not visible. Now in the menu, you can see the UI just fine. The song select, leaderboards, etc. Once we go into a song, you will see our menu camera turns off and our playing camera turns on. Almost the same, but this one has the UI toggle disabled. That was a simple use case, like I said. let's try and up the difficulty. You may have noticed before, the mod offers a few presets when adding cameras to your view. I'll add both of these cut cameras, and I'll add a third to make it positionable. Then I'll make two more positionable cameras, and another first person. And lastly, I'll make one more third person camera. If you haven't set up any scenes yet, your game may or may not be lagging a little. You don't have to do all of this at the same time like I am, but I've chosen this method right now. I will now rename these cameras for the sake of organization. I also went ahead and configured different settings for a few of these cameras. That's why some appear to be different now. If you have this mess of cameras, make them smaller and move them around. We'll fix it in a bit. Now, let's assign to the respective scenes. The two cut cameras and the third person will go to playing. The front avatar camera, first person, and the top view will go to playing 360. And lastly, I will also add the front camera and an extra third person camera to playing Modmap. Now let's go to each of those scenes and line things up. After a bit of tweaking, now we have four scenes that will trigger automatically as we move around the game. The menu, when playing a normal chart, when playing a 360 chart, and when playing a mod chart. These are only some ideas, feel free to set things up however you'd like. I will now share a few examples of different cameras. With the use of transparency, and a mod, I have a slice visualizer. You can combine this camera with the 2D slice visualizer, Dibreeze, or the one you see here is Nataluna slice visualizer. This camera is also using the orthographic view and a limited render distance. You can also use transparency to have an avatar camera with no background. I used the orthographic view for my top camera for 360 maps. Here you can see what it looks like with it on or off. Here's another example of a first person, third person camera. I edited the position and rotation values in the camera configuration to move it back, and I also disabled pivoting first person offset. Also, aside from the first person and positionable cameras, there's another type, attached. But keep in mind that this camera is undocumented and it may or may not change in the future. If you manually edit the camera's configuration and type attached, save it, and hit Ctrl+Shift+F1, a new field in the file will show up. Here, I believe you can type the name of any object in a scene, and the camera will try to attach to it. For example, we can attach it to the UI elements. Here are the names that you can use. With that in mind, you can use transparent cameras to add the UI to your desktop view in different ways. Or attach it to your sabers? But why? Camera2 also allows you to have custom scenes, for when you want to have a camera set up that doesn't fit the predetermined scenes. To set them up, let's go ahead and find the scenes file. Edit it with a text viewer of your choice. In my case, I've been using Notepad++ this whole time. In the description, I will leave a piece of text that you can copy and then paste over here. You will go down to this area and highlight it. Then all you have to do is click paste. It should look something like this. In this section here, you can name your scene. I will put right saber camera for now. In this section here, you can place as many cameras as you would like. To do that, let's go to the cameras folder, and here you can see your camera names. I will copy and paste the main camera. Then I will copy and paste the avatar camera. And then, since I need another camera, I will go after this quotation, add a comma, and then hit enter. I will add two more quotations and then find the next camera. This time I'll copy right saber camera and then paste it in between. And that's it. That's one custom scene set up. If I want another custom scene, all I do is grab from here to here, copy. After this bracket, I put another comma, hit enter, and then hit paste. Now we have an exact copy as the one above. Then you can modify it as much as you want. With this one, I have deleted the third camera I had up here, and then changed this one to Cut Visualizer. Once again, feel free to add as many as you'd like, just make sure to have a comma after each scene, and then on the last one, leave it without a comma. When you have custom scenes, you'll be able to find and switch between them on the Mods tab in Song Selection. Another way to switch between scenes is by using hotkeys. I'll leave a link in the description for all the keys that you can probably use. Try to not use F1, as that key already brings you back to the default scene. In my case, I use the F2 to F15 keys. Unity doesn't like getting to F24, I guess, but feel free to try any that you see on the list. All you have to do to set up hotkeys is to come to this area, and here you will see I have one for you. In this case, we have F2 triggering the scene example. I currently don't have any scene called example, so in order to link a hotkey to a scene, we copy the scene name and then we paste it on here. And now, anytime I press F2, it will trigger the Beat Saber cam scene. If I need another hotkey, I will add a comma, hit enter, add the quotations, I'm gonna type F3, then the two dots, and then another set of quotations. We copy and paste the other scene name. And that's it, custom scene setup. As you can see from this view, I can now use the F2 and F3 keys to switch between my scenes. And if I hit F1, we go back to the default scene of this area on the game, in this case, the menu. One more setting here, AutoswitchFromCustom. If this value is set to true, whenever you change scenes in the game, for example going from the menu into a song, the scene will automatically switch to the default scene. In this case, it will be to the playing song scene. I like to leave this setting on false, so that I can control whenever it leaves the custom scene. I do sometimes forget to go back to default though. The last thing I can think of to say is mention movement scripts once again. I don't use them very much, so I'm not able to provide a lot of detailed information, but feel free to visit the Camera2 Wiki and try to learn a little bit about it in here. I will give you two examples though. While playing, people from chat can switch to a camera that orbits around the player platform for a minute. Another example is, if you set loop to false, you can make a sort of intro animation when you load up into a song. Or you can even use it in the menu. Again, sorry for not being able to be more detailed on this section. And I think this brings us to the end. Hopefully you learned at least one new thing about Camera2. If you did, come say, hey thanks, on my Twitch chat if you'd like, or in the comments. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. I'll try to answer best I can. Other than that, thanks for watching.